I said it, didn't I? That there were two Habs stories that I wanted to cover for Sunday, January 31st. The first one was the Mete thing. The second one here is Cole Caufield. Should we call him Cole Caufield? Is that appropriate now? I feel like some people have already been calling him Cole Caufield, but Cole Caufield is just coming off of what was probably one of the biggest weekends we have seen out of any of these NCAA players this year. I don't know the numbers on that, but I'm going to say this year, because Cole Caufield, the top Montreal Canadiens prospect, playing for the University of Wisconsin Badgers, a 5'7", 5'8", 15th overall right-wing sniper who knows how to dish a puck as much as he's able to bury it, just had himself a beautiful weekend playing against the Michigan State Hockey Club. For the Wisconsin Badgers, Caufield played in both the games. The first game on Friday, January 29th, the Badgers defeated Michigan State 6-0. On the second game, which was earlier yesterday, they won 4-1. Out of the total of 10 goals that Wisconsin scored against Michigan State on the weekend, Cole Caufield had a point on 7 of them. Cole Caufield has wrapped up his weekend with 7 points and 4 goals in 2 games played. This guy is an absolute goal-scoring machine, and I can't stress just how good this guy has been playing so far in these games. Against Michigan State on January 29th, we saw a few goals starting things out really quickly. First off, it was a very beautiful play. It's Linus Weisbach who sends it over to Cole Caufield, and what he does with the puck is beautiful. He takes it, he's on the right side, he spins, he opens the shooting lane towards the goal, he shoots, he scores. Beautiful. It's in the back of the net, baby. You love to see it. Cole Caufield is all the way up here with his 10th goal on the season. Then, give it another period. It's Taipalt and Bice, Inamoto, they're over here, they send the puck in deep. Caufield, who's down low, he swoops out in front, swats it over towards the goal, it finds the back of the net. That's his second point of the game, second goal of the game, his 11th goal on the season. And things are looking very, very good for the Wisconsin Badgers. Then, go over another period, and all of a sudden, it's Cole Caufield who sends the puck up to Dylan Holloway, who comes in on a very, just absolutely beautiful breakaway chance. He absolutely dekes the goalie's pants off. Gets it through the 5-hole. Caufield, 3rd point of the game. I could easily make this a video about Dylan Holloway too, but I wanted to expand a little bit more on Caufield and how exactly he was able to play, because the next day, which was yesterday, 2 goals, 2 assists, man. This guy is an absolute legend. The first assist, it's a Linus Weisbach goal in the second period. Caufield and Weisbach have the 2-on-1. Caufield comes in, he slows down, and he sends the puck over. A very nice, beautiful play for Linus Weisbach, adding another goal to his repertoire this season. And then you give it a little bit more after that, because Cole Caufield on the power play sends the puck over to Taipalt and Bice. It's a very nice, like, kind of tic-tac-toe sort of play. It's the similar kind of vibe with the JT Miller to Bo Horvat in the slot kind of thing in the power play. Caufield takes it on the left side. He just passes it over into the middle. Pelton Bice is there. He shoots. He scores. Beautiful. 2 assists on the night for Caufield. But things don't end off there, because just 2 minutes later, also in the 3rd period, it's Weisbach and Holloway. They get the assists as they send over a Caufield pass. Caufield is on the Ovechkin spot. He loads up, raises the stick up high, slams it down. Pinpoint accurate short side snipe as the puck absolutely just rifles itself into the goal. Cole Caufield gets his first goal of this game and his 3rd point of the game, and then he had the empty net goal as well with about 35 seconds left in the hockey game, wrapping up what was his 7-point weekend in 2 games played. Cole Caufield, if you take a look at where things are right now, he's at 14 goals, 14 assists, 28 points in 18 games, bro. 18 games. Go over to the entirety of the NCAA and see that Caufield is tied for first in the nation in points. He is first in the nation in goals by a long shot. And all the other guys that are over here in the point race, the guy he's tied with, Odin Tufto, he's a senior. You have the guy underneath him, Brandon Cruz, he's a senior. You have Shane Pinto, very good Ottawa Senators prospect. He's a sophomore as well as Caufield. But then everybody else, Linus Weisbach, Cameron Wright, Nick Swaney, Kawaguchi, these are all seniors over here. Caufield has more points than all of them. He's got more goals goals than all of them. And it's funny because you can take a look at the production, take a look at what this guy is doing in terms of the goals and the assists and say, oh yeah, he's a very good offensively capable producer, but what else does he have? What does he have when he's not scoring the puck? Well, you watch him play this year, this is a guy who's got some very good wheels, a very good defensive instinct, and a very good nose for the net, even when he doesn't score points. Caufield's a guy who, when he gets the puck on the left wing, he's able to just fly with it, and he's not afraid to pull off a little fancy deke once in a while, and for some reason, they usually work. Not saying it's guaranteed to work at the NHL level with NHL-caliber players, but so far, out of all we've seen in the NCAA and at the World Juniors too, Caufield, with those little inside, off-the-inside of his skate touch dekes and all that stuff, you know, the fancy kind of pull the right stick down, press L1 and move it up kind of dekes. He does those on the rush. He does those in the power play, and they work. He's consistently finding moves to create space for himself, and when he doesn't have the puck, he's on backchecking, stealing it away, and he's actually doing a very good job at that, despite being the small, undersized forward that he, quite frankly, is. But at this point, it's becoming less and less of an issue, because now it's like, okay, if Cole Caufield was 6'1", maybe we wouldn't ever have that conversation or that discourse saying that he was potentially not going to be a good hockey player because of the size difference. But now it's like, well, he is a good hockey player. He's literally like the top point producer in the entire NCAA. Yeah, like, that's good. That's really good. I don't know what to tell you. Undersized guys can be good at the NCAA level, I get that, and sometimes they don't translate into the NHL. But for the ones that do translate, don't you wish you would have had an opportunity at getting talents like that? Alex DeBrincat got 40 goals in the NHL 1 year. That was a few years ago. He's still got a lot of potential to grow. So, for Caufield, I don't want to hear any of it anymore, man. Until we see this guy in a Montreal Canadiens sweater, he is literally doing everything in his power to exceed all expectations. Everything that he could have done, he's doing. Other than, of course, you know, converting at the World Juniors like he could have. He had a lot of chances, but he just didn't bury them. Sure, he had points, but it's like he could have had so much more, you know? The only other thing I guess he could have done was probably score a hat trick a game, but like, in terms of the actual on-ice production, as well as all the other aspects away from the puck too. He's good, man. He's really good. And with all the news we had earlier from Marc Bergevin talking about how the plan for Caufield is to join the team, whether that be Laval or the Canadiens once the season is over, who knows? But I said it at the end of the last video, man. I want to say it again. I'm just so excited because by the end of 2021, once we're all outside again, we're all vaccinated and all that stuff, we might have already seen a whole bunch of highlights of Caufield with the blue and red Montreal Canadiens hockey club sweater scoring some of those beautiful goals and making some of those beautiful dekes. Tell me in the comments what you thought about Cole Caufield's monster weekend, which puts him at the top of the world in terms of prospect production prosperity. I hope you enjoyed this video. So, Ash Rose 99. And bye.